The plaza was entirely filled with bodies, and most of them were dead. That was Naftali's first impression. He reeled and nearly fell. Then he blinked the image away. They were not bodies. They were people, living people, swarming the square, all talking at once. He knew why. He'd already heard the bitter choice that had been laid at the feet of his kinfolk. Stay and convert, or leave. And not just leave, but leave everything. People were weeping, and not only the women. Men sobbed openly. Those he knew would be the ones who were planning their own exiles. Those who had already decided to stay could not be so bold as to weep in public. As he crossed the square, the people persisted in morphing into bodies in his eyes. "Not now," he whispered, "not now." But Naftaly Cresques was a bit touched, and always had been. He saw things, generally unpleasant things, and it was not simply a matter of willing the visions away. He had to wait for them to pass. Right now, they did not seem to feel like passing. The fact that he hadn't slept well the night before was probably not helping. He felt himself collide with someone, and that seemed to be enough to quiet his mind, and his vision snapped back to reality. A girl. He'd bumped into a girl, who responded by smacking face first into the ground. He hadn't bumped her hard, but she was so slightly built a child could have knocked her over. As he bent to help her get up, he realized it was Toba Perez, with her uncovered hair braided like a crown around her head. He didn't know her, not really, but he did know her history. Dead mother, absent father, raised by her grandfather, who had once served the Emir of Rimon and had a small fortune until he lost it, though how he'd lost it was the subject of a great deal of speculation. The pendant that she wore around her neck had come askew, and she straightened it before moving on.